Oh, brothers and sisters, got a tennis ball. Tennis players, they just lose their balls. Anyways, I have something to talk about that. I was in the secret garden, of course, covered by palm trees, getting shade under some palm trees. But really, real talk, okay? Now, I really have to express this, okay? This has been on my mind. Hence, one percenter. And lifer. For lifer. Okay, so I was with the Uber driver the other day, and we had, like, this incredible, like, spiritual talk, and this is, like, the third time that I've had the most, like, I tipped one of my Uber drivers in LSD. Don't tell nobody. That was cool. He was a deadhead. Whatever. My point is this, brothers and sisters, I grew up a very privileged life, and I'm aware of this, but I ended up in a spot where I enjoyed it very much. And the man said that people kind of look down, and I totally understand, people kind of look down upon people that have less money. How do I feel about that? How do you, ask yourself, how do you feel about that? Okay, just because you got money, that you're looking down on people. Well, I was taught to treat the janitor just as well as the president. True story. That's what I was taught. And with that said, so I grew up privileged, but what's the difference really? I was right next to the neighborhood that I would go to every day that was less privileged, but when I say privileged, I mean with stupid shit. That my point is, money is not the answer to everything. Like Jim Carrey said, I wish everybody could have money, pew, just to see that it's not the answer. True story, man. So, and somebody left in one of my comments that they're able to slip through the cracks of the matrix. Shout out to the person that slipped that in my comment section, because I do appreciate that comment. But everybody, he said, gets so mad at them because he's able to slip through the cracks of the matrix, and he doesn't even need money to get around, like... True story, I've kind of done it myself when I went homeless in San Francisco. My brothers and sisters, to be happy in life, you don't need abundance of money, but it will work to your benefit if you know how to work it to your benefit. But you treat people, every person in life, you have to treat them the same with empathy, respect, as long as they respect you. If they don't respect you, then we got a little problem. In all reality, never judge a book by its character. I am guilty of judging gay people because, well, I've been tried by them, and that shit really pisses me off, to be quite honest. But I was thinking today, I was thinking to myself today, why should I be judging these people? It's not my business what they do. So, it's almost like looking down on a person. It's judgment. Like, judge a person based on your feelings, but don't judge a book by its cover. Meaning, judge a person based on your intuition, but never judge a book by its cover. Well, how do I say this? The most meanest looking person on earth could be the nicest person on earth. I've truly seen this personally myself. Like, now I'm not going to say they look mean. They just... And then the nicest person on earth could be the meanest motherfucker on earth. Like, that's how it works. So you have to understand that just because you have money doesn't make you better than anybody else. Just because you got things going for you doesn't make you better than anybody else. In this time right now, in the times that we are, it's very important that we band together and we stick together because... Watch the purge, man. Come on, Kevin King. Two stupid dogs. He's just hot.
He's so cute.
So, just don't look down on people and... Oh, immigration. The next thing I want to speak about. Immigration laws, okay? Do you understand that we... Do you know what America did during World War II? When the Jewish people came to America... Now Israel, ironically, has all the money, which is ironic, kind of. But on point, Israel, Jewish people came to America for asylum. And you know what we did? I had nothing to do with it, but you know what Americans did? They sent them on their happy way. I don't really know too much about it. I don't know why they did it, but that's wrong. Immigration, dude, like, people deserve, like, this promised land. So when I meet, this man was Haitian. I love my Haitians, I ain't gonna lie. I love them, dude. I love them to death. And my Jamaicans, shout out to my Jamaicans and all my brothers and sisters out there. The man was Haitian, and he had the kindest heart. I could see in his eyes, he had the kindest heart. He lived here for, about 22 years, I believe. 23 years, he said. But he had the most gentlest heart, and he had a bunch of children. He said, there's nothing like true love from your children. My children. The man expressed to me that also he wanted me to hand down this message to you. If you want to hear from the universe right now, in this time, you are starseed, indigo, empath. Drink a lot of water and fast. That's what he told me. And these are spirit guides that are put into my life. When I say spirit guides put into my life, I mean literally put into my life. Okay? These people are literally put in my life. It's not by accident. Point being is this, do not judge a book by its cover, because you never know who that person could be. For example, actually, I remember seeing this video, I believe it was a Jamaican, some celebrity that was dressed up like a homeless person and went around and people were just judging him, you know what I mean? It was wrong, like, you can't judge people like that.
Back to my
there's more. Back to my story. Everybody get ready for the pirate flag. Blackbeard is back. But honestly though, with all I said, do not judge a book by its cover. I'm guilty of doing it in the past. All of us are really guilty of doing this. So with that said, put up your pirate flags and get ready, because the time is coming. And with that said, my brothers, may peace be with you, also with you. Never judge a book by its color. And you know what? Gay people, I do believe in reincarnation, like, for all the gays out there, like, so, in the past life, maybe they were a gay person, gay guy, maybe they were a girl in their past life. True story, man, like, think about that. I don't know. It's a divine masculine and feminine, and you need to be in balance with yourself as a male, with the divine masculine and divine feminine. If you don't have both those traits, you won't spin like 69. With that said, peace be with you, also with you, my children. You have a great day, brothers and sisters. Great. Raise those vibes. Peace. You so great.
You think there's something wrong with your mind?
Nope, not a thing, Doc. Not a thing.
No. You're not crazy. See, the world is crazy.
Just misunderstood. And motherfuckers are scared of what they don't understand.
Absolutely. We have special ways of helping you, Wayne.
Help yourself.
Oh, I help myself all the time here. We want to... Ah! Where's the security around this bitch?
Nigga, tell me something I don't know. Like, where the fuck did my heart go? And show me something I haven't seen. And give me what helped Martin sleep on the same night he had a dream. And take me to where I've never been, but not to where I'll never be. And I ain't never scared, but I'm scared of me. Me versus me, I need a referee. Need weaponry, especially if the treasury in jeopardy. Fuck deputy, big letter B. Need equity, need credit clean. To trafficking, from peddling. Like everything from amphetamines to medicine. These niggas sweeter than nectarine. You so crazy. You so
crazy. You so crazy.